Folks, there was just a few days ago I had posted a story about how there was these dogs that were in trouble, and I spoke with the owner, and then I found a miraculous local business owner who was basically able to take 9 dogs in an emergency situation. Well, I mean, I just don't even know what to say at this point, but the deal fell through because the person who owns the dogs just changed her mind. And now I'm gonna give you a little bit of background info and show you what's going on at the house. So apparently there was a breakup, you know, 2 people living together with a family at a home, and there's a breakup. The bills ain't been paid, the house getting foreclosed, they gotta go. And the sale is to be like a vacant property, so no person can be living at the house. But the property can still be there. You know, you get to clear out your property over a, you know, reasonable period of time. And one thing that is considered property is pets. So imagine you got 2 dogs, you got 7 puppies, and you leave them in a home that's now vacant, and there's viewings going on because the house is for sale, and you only go there once a day or twice a day, maybe, for a total of 2 hours a day maximum to feed and socialize the dogs. Do these dogs need more than 2 hours a day? That's a question I'm asking you. And where is the line, you know? The person who owns these dogs says that bylaw has been by and said it's fine. That's what they say. I'm not so sure that bylaw said it's fine. I think probably bylaw said that there's no action that they can take because there's nothing illegal happening. But that's also something that's judged by the officer discretion. So I guess I wanted you to see what's going on here and tell me if you thought that there were any bylaws in Medicine Hat being broken by this scene existing. And I mean, I just want to also mention that this is a terrible position to put your real estate agent in. How are you supposed to sell your home to get the money to pay off the debts you got if you got 9 dogs in the house? Like, who comes to the viewing of a potential home they're going to buy and sees 7 puppies pooping all over the kitchen floor and wants to buy the house? I mean, that aspect of it doesn't make sense. But the reason that I heard about this story, we neighbors and concerned people around the area contacting me. And then, you know, I find out that the house is for sale. So of course I can ask for a viewing and go through. And that's how I got this video. I want you to tell me what you think of this video. I want you to tell me if you think that bylaw should be acting on this and how you feel about this scene.
These steps scare me, and they have ever since.
I could tell from the picture they were bowed, but that's a whole new level.
Yeah. Of course, good. Our little creatures come bounding out, so we have to close this door.
Mm-hmm.
Oof. I got the cats apprehended. That's all Bala would touch.
Against the smells and stuff a little bit, you know?
Hi.
This one's friendly.
Hi,
this one will nip if you pet him. All right. Well, Mr. Man, I will let you have the king hold of the house.
Come on. Come on.
Oh, hey, buddy. Hey, buddy.
Come on.
Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy.
There he is.
That's why the harness on him, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yes.
This one's the absolute sweetheart.
Look at you. Yes.
Oh. You, I don't.
Are we allowed to come in?
Absolutely.
Am I allowed to come in? Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I see you.
I was asking for permission from the man in the house.
No, you know what I mean?
They yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. 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 Oh. Mama, you done with feeding boobies or what? You all done with that?
Only time they get fed is when she comes down here and rearranges things with her.
Yeah. And then, I guess the thing, I mean, yeah, I mean, it's totally fine. I have access. I have water too. I don't think. Oh, I don't see water right now. Oh, yes, I do. There is a water. The level of contamination is kind of high. Have you, I mean...